Stephen Miller is in charge of negotiating immigration. We're going nowhere.
Breaking news. Trump's caca smothers DACA. Good evening, America, and those whose silence is easily bought by tax cut. It's official. Trump has broken the U.S. government, and it's being shut down. It's also reported that Jared Kushner is looking for another government that Trump can play with, but we here at MSM have not been able to confirm that. To help illuminate the shutdown, we are joined by a generic politician.
Well, thank you for having me here on Fake News.
So, generic, how did we get here?
Well, Andy, the president ended DACA protections 4 months ago and told Congress to fix it. He asked for a bipartisan bill of love. We delivered it. He nixed it. Then the Dems presented another deal. He said yes. Then an hour later, the White House said negativo. We asked the Dems to kick the can down the road with a continuing resolution. We even threw in a chip program to melt their hearts. They said they hated kids and shut it all down.
To be fair, the Republicans have blocked chip renewal for the last 4 months. So, does that mean you hate kids?
Don't be absurd. We love kids that are above the poverty line. This is a Schumer shutdown. Trademark.
Sorry, this is the first shutdown in history where the Republicans have controlled all three branches of government. Sounds more like a McConnell shutdown. Trademark.
Don't blame us. We can't fix this when Trump changes his mind more than costume changes at a Taylor Swift concert.
And to address what Trump really wants, we are joined by White House senior decaying policy advisor Stephen Miller.
Can I just say that your arrogant tone is obvious to all of America?
Sure. So, Stephen, where does Trump stand on immigration and DACA now?
Where I tell him to, Andy.
And where is that?
I'm glad you asked that. As of now, it's nominal protections in exchange for the wall.
I see.
But after my next Jedi mind trick attempt, it should be deportation for all and an electrified wall with boiling oil cauldrons and flaming manure catapults. Ow.
That's not really a bill of love.
Whatever. You think being one of the few white supremacists in a Santa Monica high school was any picnic?
What does that even have to do with—
I am always astonished how you liberal elites keep defending foreign rapists and murderers in our country.
Now, Stephen, studies show undocumented people are far less likely to commit crimes than U.S. citizens.
Is the meeting over? I have to go. It's imperative I'm the last one the president speaks to before he begins his eeny, meeny, miny, moe decision-making process. Don't close the door!
Ugh, I need a bath. To get a better grasp on how this is affecting so-called dreamers, we are joined by the Garcias, the Lopezes, and the Morenos.
Oh, thank you for having us, Andy. It is an honor to be here.
Mr. Garcia, how old were you when you were brought to this country?
I was around,
Immigration! Hands
what are
air!
You doing?
Jesus!
Mama, look out!
Okay. Mrs. Lopez, you were—
Immigration, you have the right
no,
to
make sense. No, 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 no!
Immigration!
I just— Oh, okay, Coming up, the porn star and the president. How stormy was their affair? I'm sorry. No. Stop the music. This isn't news. It's us recovering from our 2016 integrity amnesia. I'm shutting this episode down, too. Turn off the lights. Families are being torn apart, and there are people in the White House who want that to happen. It's just not funny. Everyone, go home and hug your families. Good night.
And God bless the United States. Fox and Friends in the morning, they're very honorable people. I have nothing to do with Russia. News is fake. You'll have false sources that maybe don't exist. The made-up story, it's all fake news. It's all fake news.